Yo, what's the deal, good people? Eric Taylor, Big E Astrology. I'm busy, back in the house, in effect, in the place. Finishing up my Juno house series in your place. I don't know. It's Juno in the 10th house, all right? So we're talking about Juno in the 10th house in your natal birth chart. I'll break down what Juno means, the 10th house, and tell you where you can find that love at, all right? And this is a great time, right? It's Libra season, the Libra birth chart sale, and also a good time to book a mini love audio chart reading for only $53, where we do look at Juno, Venus, Jupiter, 5th house, 7th house, stuff like that, all right? So that's biggieastrology@gmail.com. Juno is the asteroid for long-term relationships, commitment, and marriage. Married. So Juno was Jupiter's wife. It does have like a little Venus, like a little Libra Scorpio energy to it. Okay. And so it is an indicator, right? Depending on the sign in the house, it tells the story of potentially who or the character traits of the type of person you could be in a committed relationship with and where you can meet them, all right? So it's a puzzle you put all together. Now the 10th house, okay, I wanna explain this clearly because I'm a Western tropical astrologer that uses the whole sign system. And the midheaven, which is that point, right, where you vibrate in public, usually the energy for your career can be in the 9th, 10th, or 11th house. So when we're just looking at the 10th house, we're looking at the legacy, your public image, your reputation. Oh, I know that. That's Eric. That's Cheryl's son. Stuff like that, right? How you're known in the world. It's the government, the authority, your father, your workplace, your work environment, okay? So that's what you're seeing in the 10th house. The midheavens there can also be the career. So we'll get into that with this Juno placement in the 10th house and your father. So literally, if you have Juno in the 10th house, your father can introduce you to the person that you marry. That can actually happen, right? Or you can meet them at a government job. Or this could be someone that really is very focused on their career. Right? Let's say you had Juno and Aquarius in the 10th house. This could be like a friend at work or someone you meet working in robotics or IT or technology or some strange, innovative, futuristic, weird career. Or maybe Juno, Aquarius, 10th house, you marry a professional astrologer. Okay? You have Sagittarius here that could be a professor or an archaeologist or a pastor, a preacher of a church. Okay, you have Juno and Gemini here. There may be somebody that works with their hands, or they could actually be an actor. You know, they've got a lot of different skills. So when you have Juno 10th house, it's, you know, showing the energy you can attract, but also, you know, what you're looking for in that partner. Okay, so each sign will flavor the story. But the 10th house really lets you know that you could meet somebody that you fall in love with for the committed relationship or marriage that you work with. You meet at work, or maybe they hire you. Maybe you get, or maybe they work next door to your office or down the hall in the same building, right? Workplace, work environment. You can literally meet them when you're going out for a lunch break. I wouldn't say smoke break, hopefully you're not doing that, but smoke break or coffee break, right? Or just in your local community from your job, right? You work in an accountant office and then, you know, down the street or whatever, somebody works in a salon or, you know, works as a doctor or therapist, and you guys just, you know, meet at the local restaurant for lunch or something. All right. So it's the workplace or the work environment. Now you could have a government job. They could work for the government. They also can be someone that knows your father or your father's business friend. It's their daughter or their son, and you get introduced. Things like that can all play out. Now, you want to see if there's any major aspects to like Venus, Sun, Mercury, Mars, you know, whether it's opposing it in the fourth or conjunct in the conjunction in the 10th house within 0 and 10 degrees. That could flavor this Juno placement and energy. You know, there could be a trine from the second or sixth house, right? That can, you know, and you would want it, if it's, we're dealing with an asteroid, you want it to be really tight orb, maybe 1 degree off, 2 degrees the most, okay, with Juno. But Juno Taurus here, maybe you meet somebody who's an architect or landscaping or a banker or professional chef. Okay. So Juno in the 10th house is someone that could be literally married to their career. You know, they never are at home. It can also describe that as well. You know, so we're talking about potentially connecting with someone that's a workaholic or super driven to achieve in their career, their goals, and things like that. Okay. Someone who's a CEO, a boss, has their own business. Right. The head of HR, all different things. So just remember, Juno's part of the puzzle. It's not the only indicator. If you're a woman looking for a man, you want to look at the Jupiter. If you're a man looking for a woman, you look at a Venus. If it's same sex, Jupiter, Venus, Venus. And then Mars is always going to be the boyfriends in the chart. Okay? Mars is boyfriends and brothers. So just some helpful hints to let you understand. But definitely, I would book, if you're already in a relationship, a synergy compatibility chart, which really is deep and explains things like nobody's business to really help you out, right? Or the mini love chart reading, okay? But either way, Juno in the 10th house, make room for love. Don't be so married to your career and all that that you can't, you know, spend some time in a committed relationship. You really need that. You want that. Okay? You want to be in a place where you can balance your professional career and making some adjustments or sacrifices to be in the long-term relationship, commitment, or marriage. You may be the one hiring the person. You may be the one that, you know, knows their father, right? You've got a coworker that's older than you or a boss, and they're like, you know what? I really like you. You may, meet my daughter, you know, and introduce you like that. So there's just a different, many multitudes of ways that Juno in the 10th house can play out in the natal birth chart. So hit me up. You want to know more about this placement and comment down below about your sign. And if you've ever dated anybody at work, or if you've met your spouse there, or you could even have similar careers as your spouse, Juno could play out that way as well. You know? And your pops could be up in a cookie jar in a marriage, you know, or trying to connect you with people. That can happen too, you know, kind of an arranged marriage or just, you know, dad trying to look out. Yeah. So, Eric Taylor, Biggie Astrology. That is Juno in the 10th house. And make sure this Saturday you sign up for Astrological Coffee Talk. Sign up now, but it's going to be Saturday, October 14th at 4 p.m. Eastern, 2 hours, $20. Teaching a lesson. And we're going to look at the charts and break them down together as a group. Building that astrology community, the solar eclipse on October 14th, and the lunar eclipse in Taurus Scorpio. On October 28th, that solar eclipse is Libra Aries axis. The Libra, well, it's the Libra Sun and Moon, 21 degrees. And it's a Sagittarius rising chart. You don't want to miss out on that, okay? So just hit me up, biggieastrology@gmail.com. Bye, Juno in the 10th house. DS's house. DS's house. Ah! All right, later.